What if I told you that this is VS Code? Using Gdscript in VS Code is much easier than you might expect, and it comes with a lot of advantages. So let's see how to use it and what this is all about. To make Gdscript work in VS Code, you only need to install a single extension. So inside your VS Code, open the Extensions panel, search for godot-tools, and install it. This plugin is used to connect Godot and VS Code together, but it also comes with a lot of interesting new features. After that, we just need to tell where Godot is. So click on the gear icon and open up the settings. You need to set the path to either the Godot 3 or Godot 4 executable that your project uses. There are also other options here, but it should work as it is unless you change Godot's default server ports. Now we just need to configure Godot. So let's close this, scroll to Godot configuration, and make sure to copy this exec flag string. I'll also put them in the description. Inside Godot, open the editor settings and go to the text editor external. Enable the Use External Editor, and turn on the advanced settings. On exec path, search for your VS Code executable path. On Windows, that is the code.exe file. And finally, paste the exec flags we copied before here. Now when you click your script files, it will open VS Code instead of inside Godot. There is also a few extra options you can use to ensure Godot will pre-import and compile script files changed inside VS Code. But since Godot 4.4, you probably don't need these anymore. So just keep it in mind if you are using a previous version of Godot. They are the Save on Focus and Import Resources when on Focus inside the Interface Editor and the Auto Reload script on External Change inside Behavior. If everything is working, you'll see the connected icon at the bottom. You need to have Godot open for this to work. If you don't, it will fail to connect to the language server that tells it how Gdscript works. And you'll see the icon at the bottom showing that it has not found Godot. But before we start using this, I highly recommend you install Godot VS Code theme. This will give you the same colors as the Godot editor, along with Godot-specific highlights. It comes with two color themes, the default Godot colors, and a more high-contrast one. And Error Lens is another must-have extension that will show the code errors along the lines. You can configure its delay so it will only show errors after you finish typing, and a lot more options. Now back to Godot tools. It comes with a lot of cool features. Have you ever wondered what type an auto-assigned variable really is? You can now enable Gdscript Inlay hints for that. And now the real variable type is nicely shown after the other types assignments. No more guessing around. There are a couple of ways you can run your game from VS Code. For the first one, we need to set up a debug configuration. So open the Run Debug panel, click on the Create Launch.json file, and choose Gdscript Godot Debug. And now you can simply run your game by pressing the play button or using the shortcut key F5. This will run the main scene of your game. But you can also run individual scenes by using the icon at the top. We'll see how that works in a moment. Another cool feature of Godot tools is how it handles scenes. Let's open this Boat Tower scene. The scene file here also has inlay hints, which is really useful if you ever have to fix a corrupted scene before. But besides that, you can click on the Godot icon to show the scene preview. This will display the scene tree of the current open scene, and we can also run the game from my specific scene. So let me open the World Desert scene, and use the icon at the top to run the selected scene. You can also pin a scene. So when you are working on other files, you can just run the pinned scene without needing to open the scene again. But one of the biggest advantages of VS Code is its powerful debugger. So let's add a breakpoint here and run our pinned scene again. You can now just hover over variables to take a quick look at their values, or use the variables panel to see all variables by context. Besides that, you have your usual watch and call stack sections. And Godot tools gives you access to the active scene tree tab. Just press the refresh button and it will show you your running game's nodes. And if you hit the eye icon while the debugger is paused, you can also inspect the nodes variables inside the inspector tab. The downside is that changing properties is not supported yet, so you can just look at the values, but maybe in the future. Godot tools has a very limited debugger console. It can print variable values for you to look around. But it can't find or call functions or execute any real code. Maybe this improves in the future, but right now, it is not of much use. Now, besides debugging, VS Code has a much more reliable autocomplete than Godot. And it can also control-click classes to directly open their documentation, and hover over any functions or classes to see their docs, much like Godot can now. But it even shows the docs for functions, while autocompleting them. The scene preview will also automatically open the scene that has the same name as the script file. And you can use this to drag in nodes to your code, hold Shift and release it to add the onReady var for that node. But if your script doesn't share the same name as the scene, there is another way. Let's drag the scene preview to the other side and search for our scene. This tower script here is used for the bow and cannon tower scenes, so let's open one of them. Now that the scene is open, we can lock the scene preview and go back to our script while keeping the scene tree there. And we can go back to coding and drag in our node when we need it. But that's it. Set up Gdscript for VS Code is really easy and can be very helpful for bigger projects. I hope this video helps, and until next time.